for energy, and why not? I enjoy. Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. So in this video, as you can see from the title, I am so excited. I'm happy, grateful. I can't even describe how I'm feeling. Your girl has finally clocked 1,000 subscribers. I mean, you guys have been there with me from the beginning, so why not celebrate with you guys? I don't have, you know, much to do, but I just got myself some cake, which I'm going to show you guys in a bit. I got myself some cake, though it was last minute. It was a last minute cake, but thanks to Solar Confectionery, she just made it possible for me to have it before shooting this video. She actually made it today. So I'll be sharing with you guys my secrets. Things that have helped my channel grow. And these are the little things that people overlook. I'm not going to talk about things like should have a nice thumbnail, should have a nice title. No. For me, I'm going to talk about the little things that people ignore. So the first thing is authenticity. When I started YouTube, I told myself, let people know you for who you are, you know. So what happened was, even before I started, I used to watch, like, you know, other YouTubers and all that. And I noticed something. Most YouTubers have accents. Well, I'm not saying those people are not authentic, but that's how they are. So I was like, should I also develop, you know, an accent, or I should just go in, you know, as Pretty Kombe with this Zambian accent? I don't even know what accent I have, but yeah. So I decided, like, I'm going to enter like this. I'm going to start YouTube like this. And that's how I began my journey. It's been exciting. And I have seen that authenticity is everything. Like, it will even attract you to the right people. You know, authentic people love authentic people. So, you know what I'm saying? The other thing is, I appreciate my supporters. If you follow me on Instagram, or even just on WhatsApp, if you've got my contact, you've noticed that I screenshot whenever somebody shares my link. I screenshot and reshare it. That's my way. Of course, you can have your other ways, your own ways, but for me, I always screenshot and repost on my status. That's my way of appreciating. I've noticed that people want to feel appreciated, so when I appreciate people, they'll want to help me again next time. They want to share. I didn't even expect this much support. Every time I post a new video, I always get more than 30 shares, which is like everything. And people ask me, how do you get a lot of views? How do you get what? It's through my supporters. People share, and people have really helped me grow. I don't take things personal. You know, on YouTube, there are different types of people who are going to view. There are those people who are going to come with good intentions. They're going to view and, you know, like the video, share, and leave a good comment, a genuine good comment. And there are those people who just come, dislike your video, make bad comments. Of course, most people won't even, like, put in the comments, but we just make bad comments wherever they are. And it's okay. Like, such people exist, and it shouldn't, like, bother you. It shouldn't be a setback in your process, you see. So just don't take things personal. The third one is, be your best cheerleader. Be your best cheerleader. Be your best hype man. You know, I hype myself up, and I'm not even apologetic about it. I hype myself. I will share my content, my videos everywhere, on every platform. I make sure that if people support me, I support myself even more. So I know, and this also goes with expectations. You don't expect everybody to, you know, share your stuff, to like your stuff. It's okay. But be your best cheerleader. So that even on days when you don't get the views you expect, you'll be fine with it because you know you've put in the efforts and it shouldn't like bother you. The other thing I can say is don't take things personal. Once you take things personal, I'm telling you, every setback you're going to have on your channel or whatever business you're doing, it's just going to make you low, depressed, stressed. Don't take things personal. One thing I told myself is don't aim for everybody to like you. And this has really helped me. Like, I know there are people who support me. In fact, there's a majority of people who support me. I should be caring about, 20% who feel like my content is useless or boring. No, do not take things personal. Not everybody is going to like you. It's not a must to be liked by everybody. One other thing that has helped me grow is consistency. I've tried by all means to be consistent. Of course, there was a month actually where I didn't post anything. And I feel like if I posted that month, would have been, you know, having other milestones by now. But consistency really helps. Even if it's once a week, if it's, you know, twice in a month or what, like let people know that, okay, we're going to expect a video maybe twice a week or once a week. Let people know so that people don't, you know, forget about you to say, okay, this person is no longer on YouTube or they haven't been posting for 6 months or something. So you be consistent and you're going to see in everything, consistency is key. And last thing is enjoy yourself. I told myself I am going to be enjoying. And this is how I get comments like, yeah, for energy and whatnot, I enjoy. You know, there are certain times where I have to retake certain videos just for you guys to be motivated, just for you guys to laugh, just for you guys to, you know, watch my content. But that doesn't, like, discourage me. Just today is an example. I shot this video and my phone just blacked. So I actually shot it, like, when the sun was still out, and now it's even like 18 right now and I have to edit, I have to, you know, do a lot of things, but I'm still enjoying the process. So this is what I had to share. I started to share some tips and to celebrate with you guys because you've been with me from, you know, the time I started YouTube. And also I want to give a special shout out to my loyal subscribers. These people are loyal subscribers because from the time I posted video number one up to the time I posted video number 11, they've been sharing and commenting. And for me, I always read, you know, people's comments and I respond, so I know who comments and whatnot. So these are the people who I've seen have been supportive from the very first day. If you don't see yourself, if you don't like find yourself on this list, don't get offended. These are just people I've noticed and I just feel like they should be appreciated. I also appreciate each effort like everybody's making. Of course, certain people joined the journey when maybe I was on my fourth video and what, and maybe couldn't watch the previous videos. So special shout out goes to the following. I had to write this down. Kayla Nakazwe, Lombe Kachimfia, Cookie Kanchule, Mwaka Muyangwa, Emmanuel Chihusa, Ngenda Kakubo, Bob Mukosha, Chonde Hampongo, and Ngosa Kalunga. You guys have really done the most, like, your loyal subscribers. I also want to just appreciate everybody for, you know, always commenting, keeping the views high, you know. It really means a lot and I appreciate you guys. Wait, I actually said I have cake, so let me just get the cake from the fridge.
A few moments later.
So this is a red velvet cake by Solar Confectionery. You can check the page out on Instagram. She really makes amazing cakes. So this was actually a fast one, but she actually did her thing. I actually didn't expect it to be ready fast. If you haven't subscribed, I mean, I'm on 1,000 and you still don't want to subscribe. So here is to more wins, more milestones, more support, and what else? Yeah, so this goes to a new journey, road to 2,000 subscribers.